Okay, class. Assalamualaikum. So now we continue our discussion on cumulative frequency table. So by right, you sudah tahu what is frequency table, right? Frequency table, they give you a number of class and frequency value, right? So cumulative frequency of the I class, I class means class number 1, number 2, number 3 lah. I present equal to 1, 2, 3 lah. Depend on your number of class. Is the total frequency of the I class and the second the class before the I class. Means the formula should be for cumulative frequency, frequency for the present class plus frequency of this one, frequency I minus 1, means frequency before the present class. Means before the first class, we have zero frequency, right? Frequency tak wujud, tidak ada data, right? So the number of frequency equal to zero before the first class. This is the first class, second class, third class, and fourth class, fourth class, fifth class. So the frequency of the first class is 12. So Fi means F1 plus, dia kata apa tadi? The total frequency of the I class and the class before I class. Means frequency before the I class. Before the I class is 0. 0. So cumulative frequency before the I class is 0. 0 plus 12 equal to 12, right? So for the second class, cumulative frequency, frequency of the second class plus frequency of a cumulative frequency of the first class before. So 12 plus 28, you akan dapat 40. Boleh ikut and so on lah, sampai habis. Kalau you punya total is 70, so the cumulative frequency for the last class equal to 70 lah, right? Kalau you dapat tengok, kalau frequency, total frequency you are 25, contoh lah, let's say 70, right? Then you buat cumulative frequency, you tidak dapat 70, you dapat 68. Means you salah kira. And boleh faham ah? It's supposed to get 70 juga. Boleh faham? So this one frequency table with the class boundary. Sebab apa? Lower class limit sama dengan upper class limit before that class. Boleh faham? Upper class limit for the second class equal to lower class limit of the third class. This is a class with class boundary. Boleh faham? So kalau kita tengok di bawah sikit, this one kita panggil less than frequency table. Less than frequency table means 1 less than 1. So bermaksud di sini value sebelum 1, value sebelum 3, less than frequency. So when you construct less than frequency, so you tengok ni 1 less than 3 means the first frequency should be less than 1. This one 3 less than 5 means less than 5. This one should be less than 5. This one should be less than 3. So this one should be less than 3, less than 5. So untuk construct or give nanti later on, you kena construct lagi satu, you kena add lagi satu row less than 1. Means sebelum kelas nombor 1. Boleh faham? Sebelum kelas nombor 1, ya, kelas yang tidak ada dalam frequency value lah. Boleh faham? Boleh ikut? So this one very easy lah. So this one we known as less than cumulative table. So you ada cumulative value, cumulative frequency and less than value dalam setiap class. Boleh ikut? So now kita move on to cumulative frequency curve. Cumulative frequency curve ataupun kita kenali dengan Ogive Ogive chart lah. Since dalam kelas STA 104 and QMT 181, kita tak pakai more than Ogive. kita akan pakai less than or give. So bila-bila masa pun you akan construct less than or give. That's why untuk frequency table you kena construct less than. You tak boleh cari more than. Boleh faham? Huh? So you akan belajar less than or give saja. So you tengok sini. A less than or give is a graphical presentation of the cumulative frequency table. Right, kalau you tengok tadi first chart yang kita belajar, histogram untuk quantitative variable kan. Quantitative variable, frequency, histogram, frequency polygon, frequency curve, and stem and leaf, kita hanya pakai normal frequency. Right, kita tak libatkan cumulative frequency. So untuk for less than or give, less than or give, this one kena highlight sikit. Less than or give, kita pakai cumulative frequency. So untuk cumulative less than or give, x as is represent the variable given in the form of class boundary. In the form of class boundary. So you kena highlight this one. Still you pakai class boundary. Sama juga dengan histogram. Right, class frequency polygon and frequency curve. Then y axis represent the cumulative frequency. Kalau kita tengok perbezaan di antara histogram, frequency polygon and less than or give. Histogram untuk y axis dia pakai frequency saja. Untuk less than or give, kita hanya pakai cumulative frequency, capital F. Boleh nampak? Boleh ikut? So for the y x axis kita pakai class boundary. Class boundary. Class boundary ni kita pakai less than 1, less than 3, less than 5 and so on lah. Right. Class boundary. So look at example number 2.8. Draw less than or give for the above table. Above table tadi apa? This one lah. This table. Right. Ataupun you boleh pakai table yang atas ni. Yang ini. Benda yang sama. So kalau this one you tak bagi lagi less than kan? So you kena construct less than. So to construct less than, you kena tambah lagi satu row di atas sebelum class number 1. So the frequency should be 0. Right. So determine percentage of children having age less than 6 years old. So daripada ogive you boleh cari median. Daripada ogive you boleh cari age berapa banyak children yang ada umur kurang daripada berapa value yang you suka nak cari. So to construct, let's say this is your graph paper, right? So dalam graph paper you, sebelum you start dengan first axis, you jarakkan satu kotak. Di bawah pun you jarakkan satu kotak, right? So you start, you begin to draw you punya axis lah. So let's say this one you punya axis. I draw simple lah. So this one y axis, this one x axis. X axis tadi represent apa? Class boundary. Class boundary you apa represent apa tadi? Age lah. Age in years. Right. And di sini represent you punya apa? Cumulative frequency. Cumulative frequency you apa tadi? Number of children. Why, eh? Right. So I lukis tak cantik sangat lah. You lukis dalam kertas graf, make sure cantik lah. Sebab I tak ada tool untuk lukis graf. So I lukis macam ini. So I padamkan this one. I tak nak tengok this one. So first start dengan kosong lah sini. Right. So you tengok you punya frequency table. Frequency table you. you will start from 0, 12, 40, 53 until 70. So you boleh choose apa scale you nak pakai untuk y axis. Right, this one y axis. So I letak tepi sikit lah, kecil sikit. Right. So let's say I letak base pada 10-10 lah. I letak sini 10, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. Make sure you penuhkan sehingga atas lah. Right, so I buat roughly lah. Boleh faham ha? So this one 10, this one I besarkan sedikit. So I boleh tulis this one 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70. Right, boleh faham? Boleh ikut? Boleh ikut? So by right nanti you tulis you punya scale, make sure sehingga atas lah. Right? So kalau this one 2, you boleh pakai 3 lah, sehingga atas. Boleh ikut lah. So you tengok balik you punya graph frequency table. You ada less than 1, less than 3, less than 5, less than 7 until less than 11. Kalau you tengok dekat atas ni, yang original table, I tak akan bagi this one dekat you. I akan bagi this one, this table dekat you. Right? This table only. Hanya sebelah sini saja. First column and second column saja. Apa you kena buat? You kena cari cumulative frequency. Then you kena convert this one, 1 less than 3 kepada this one. Right? This one by right, dia akan dapat less than 3, less than 5, less than 7, less than 9, less than 11. So, tadi I cakap dekat you, mesti construct satu lagi, mesti add satu lagi row dekat atas kelas sebelum. Kelas sebelum means less than 1. That's why you dapat table yang baru less than 1. Right. So apa yang nak you buat di sini untuk frequency or give, you start dengan less than 1 di sini. Let's say I'll tell di sini less than 1, less than 3, less than 5, less than 7, less than 9, less than 11. So barat juga you kena penuhkan you punya axis lah. So mungkin 2 tak cukup, I buat 3 lah ha? So I menggunakan 3 scale. 1 this one 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. Boleh faham? So nilai di bawah ni I tulis apa? This one less than 1, less than 3, less than 5, less than 7, less than 9, less than 11. Boleh faham? So now tengok balik table. Less than 1 equal to 0 cumulative frequency. Nah, this one for cumulative frequency kan? Less than 1 cumulative frequency equal to 0, less than 3 cumulative frequency equal to 12. So you masukkan value di sini. So let's say I gunakan pen biru. So less than 1 frequency dia 0. Right. Less than 3 sepatutnya 12 lah, lebih kurang dekat sini. You buat betul-betul lah. Ah, you measure betul-betul 12 tu dekat mana. Then less than 5 40, lebih kurang di sini. Right? Less than 7 53, lebih kurang dekat sini lah. I letak kat atas sikit. Right? Then less than 9 you ada 60, 68 lebih kurang dekat sini, lebih kurang dekat sini. Boleh faham? Then less than 11 supposed to be 70 lah. Boleh faham? So ogive to connect this this point, you gonna connect this point lah. So by flexible ruler. So flexible ruler, you ambil lah. Let's say I color tak banyak lah. So color apa yang menarik? kuning. Kuning is a highlight. Saya guna dia lah. So you menggunakan flexible ruler. You connect the line, the point using flexible ruler. So this is your ogive. Boleh faham? So once you sudah habis, jangan lupa you ada title. This one number of children for Y axis, age for X axis, and title you should be apa? Less than or give showing the age years of 70 children. Right. Boleh faham? This is your gift. Boleh ke? Now, I know you try buat or give dulu. Then kita akan bincang lagi soalan untuk menjawab soalan tadi. So now kita tengok soalan setelah kita sudah siap our ogive, less than ogive. So make sure you mention this one, you are the less than ogive, right? Sebab apa? You buat less than ogive. Kalau you mention ogive saja, tak betul lah, sebab kita ada dua, two type of ogive, more than ogive and less than ogive. Right, we only focus on less than ogive. Right, now look at the question. Draw less than ogive for the above table and form, and from the ogive determine this question. You ada tiga question. First, kita sudah draw less than ogive. Now, to determine the first question, percentage of children having age less than 6 years old. So children having age less than 6 years old. So you tengok di sini, less than 6, sorry, less than 6, mana you nak dapat less than 6? Ha? Less than 6 dapat berapa? This one less than 5, less than 7. So less than 6 should be in this in between 40 and 53. Right? Less than 6 should be between 40 and 53. So look at your graph paper. Right? So less than 6, kalau di sini less than 5, di sini less than 6, di sini should be less than 6. Right? Boleh nampak? So you tengok you punya table, paper, you draw straight line sehingga atas. So dia berada, sepatutnya berada di sini lah. You buat betul-betul lah. So I punya graph tak nampak betul sangat, tapi lebih kurang. So kalau you buat dalam kertas graph, dan sepatutnya you dapat betul. So kalau you buat begitu, you akan dapat berapa? Ya? Yeah? 48 and then 46 50. Right? You ada pelbagai jawapan, tapi kalau you buat betul-betul, you akan dapat 46. 48 salah, 50 pun salah. Boleh faham? Ha? So that's why you kena gariskan dengan betul-betul, gunakan flexible ruler. Kalau you salah menggunakan flexible ruler, then you tidak akan dapat jawapan yang betul. So you akan dapat 46. So macam mana you nak cari percentage? So you sudah tahu tadi, less than 6 is 46. So there's a question number 1. So you sudah tahu 46. Right? This is less than or give. You kena tahu ah, less than or give. So untuk cari percentage of age of children, children having age less than 6, So percentage pun dah cari. Nilai bahagi dengan total kali dengan 100%. So total is 70 multiply with 100%. So you akan dapat 65.71%. Right. So ini you dapat 2 markah. Boleh faham ah? So you kena tunjuk you punya jalan kira dalam OGIF. Right. Kalau you dapat 50 pun dalam OGIF you dapat 50, then kita boleh terima lah consideration. Right, plus minus. Tapi tadi kawan you tanya, tak boleh, strict. Untuk kelas I strict lah. Kalau you tak tunjuk, you punya jalan kira dalam graf. Boleh faham? Ha? So now, this is a very trick question. Kita tengok second question. So saya padam dulu. Second question dia kata apa? This one. Determine percentage of children having age more than 10 years old. So dia nak cari more than 10 years old. Oh, balik kepada kata graf tadi. Right. This one, kalau you tengok kata graf you, I tutup this one, nampak besar sikit. Less than 9 years old, less than 11 years old. So 10 ada kat mana? Midpoint lah, dia ada berada di sini lah. Right, mesti ada less than 10. Right, tapi soalan dia tanya apa?
More than 10.
Boleh faham apa yang cakap? Now, first you cari dulu nilai berada di less than 10. Less than 10 you akan dapat berapa? This one between 68 and 70. Right? Between 68 and 70. So you akan dapat lebih kurang less than 10 you dapat 69. So you sudah tahu less than 10 should be equal to 69. Tapi you nak more than 10. So you tahu satu masalah. Satu dalam problem ni sudah tahu daripada 0 hingga 70. 69 ada di sini. Boleh faham? Boleh faham draw ni boleh nampak ah? So di bawah ini bermaksud less than 10. Di atas ini bermaksud more than 10. So 70 minus 69 you dapat nilai di atas kan? Betul? Kalau nilai di bawah straight away you boleh nampak kan? 69. Kalau nilai di atas balance daripada 70 tu. 70 minus 69 divide by 70 multiply with 100%. You akan dapat 1.03. Pompa apa? 4.3%. Boleh faham? Dan logik lah 1.4 something. Sebab nilai terlalu kecil. Right. Boleh dapat logik macam tu? Boleh faham ha? That very good. So I padam this one. Boleh. Question number 3. You boleh ikut ha? Ada masalah? Do you have any problem? No? Very good. Now question number 3. Percentage of children having age between 6 and 10 years old. So apa dia nak to plain 0 until 70. You nak nilai 69 48. So you nampak sini 46. So this one 46. So nilai 69, this one less than 10. So nilai di sini sepenuh ni adalah nilai less than 10. Dan nilai 0 less than 6 hanyalah di sini. Boleh faham? Kalau you nak cari nilai di tengah-tengah sahaja, macam mana you buat? 69 minus 46. So you akan dapat nilai di tengah ni saja. Boleh faham? 69 sepenuh ni, dan you tolak nilai di sini. Dia buang di sini. So you sudah buang di sini. Di sini sudah buang. You hanya tinggal di sini. Boleh faham? So percentage of children having age between 6 and 10 years old, 69 minus 46 divide by 70 multiply with 100%. So you akan dapat berapa? 32.86%. So that's all. Boleh ikut? Ada masalah? Do you have any problem?